Chapter 25, Palma. Excerpt from the Citizens' Assembly on the Raising of Taxes on the Gridlock. Report number 385. Testimony from Mr. Francois LaRue.
What if the real hope is the friends we made along the way? Can't put a price on that, can we?
Tax conflict, not the gridlock. Or some shit like that. Can we smoke in here?
The day after the race, Palma stood in front of the Kygo's bus as the sun rose over the city. He wanted to know if Flora was okay. He had been texting her ever since he got his phone back, but she had not replied. Since the family banquet, Palma had been channeling his frustration at not being able to help into his studies and trying to uncover what his family was hiding. If it was merely a hack that had occurred, would they have been so worried about it leaking? Palma suspected that something else was on the server. It was, however, a fruitless pursuit. Nothing new had come of it, and he was thus relieved to get agency again when he got his phone back. He didn't know whether Esper and the gang was safe, and that gnawed at him. The clock was ticking, but for now, he wanted to know if Flora was okay. He knocked on the door of the bus. A few seconds later, he heard footsteps and straightened himself. Flora opened the door with a cup of coffee in hand. She whispered to avoid waking her mother.
Palma, you can't keep doing this. Seriously, how many times do I need to tell you?
I'm not here to help. I just want to know if you're okay.
I'm perfectly fine. I'm going to quit the championship. It's done. It's over. Please leave,
she said as she tried to shut the door. Palma caught it before it closed on him. Before he could understand what was going on, Flora chided him.
See, this is exactly the problem,
she said, pointing the coffee cup at Palma, forcing the door open.
You help, but in the process, you don't listen. You don't listen to what people need. You and Esper both. Esper is at least openly selfish. You hide behind your helping to make yourself feel needed. That's why. It's why you gave the job to Esper in the first place. It's why you hacked your own parents. It's why you stole a book from the library. You think you are helping, but by not actually speaking to people, you end up hurting them. You don't want to admit you selfishly want people to ask you for help.
The words hit him like the bow wave of a sonic boom. He let go of the door, but it seemed Flora did not want to end it there. Palma saw himself as a good person. It's all he strived for, to be good, to help others, to be like his parents, a public servant. It didn't make sense. Flora, he said with his heart beating through his shirt, I think you are confused, hurt, and angry at everything. If you don't want help, then I'm out. Palma bowed. I'm sorry I helped. I'm sorry I did all of this shit for you. I'm sorry I was there for you. I'm sorry that I helped you get fifth place. It's a tragedy that all of that will now go to waste. She always pretended like she knew everything. She always seemed to go about life and, in small ways, inadvertently forget that others existed. Oh, and be careful in what you do to others when you selfishly focus on only your own needs. He walked away and could hear Flora in the background whispering loudly after him.
Don't gaslight me!
Palma paced through the gridlock onto the pavement and had an urgent feeling to throw the trash can against the wall. He stopped himself as Flora's words were still ringing in his ears. Maybe he did just want to feel needed. Was that selfish? Suddenly, he didn't know. All that he did to help her, for nothing. Esper, Rulo, and Saga were in trouble, and now she just wanted to quit? It baffled him. You hide behind your helping to make yourself feel needed. You don't want to admit you selfishly want people to ask you for help. The entire time, it was always about other people. Regardless of whether that was selfish or not, to feel needed, what he had not done was take care of himself. Screw Flora. She didn't appreciate his help. Screw Esper. He used him. Screw his parents. They treated him like a teenager. It was time he helped himself. Enough was enough.